Hi, this is Srinivas Lakyam. Today we are going to discuss Linux introduction. Do you know what is Linux? Linux is an operating system. What is operating system? Do you know what is operating system? Operating system is a interface between application softwares and hardware. It is a interface between application softwares and hardware. Application softwares cannot directly communicate with hardware. Application softwares communicate via with operating system, because operating system knows about hardware. So application softwares communicate with the operating system communicate with hardware. Okay, it is a interface between application softwares and hardware. Okay, before going to start Linux operating system, let's discuss Unix operating system first. Unix operating system. So, first they introduced Multics stands for multiplex information computing system. It was introduced in 1965 by AT&T, GE and MIT. This Multics operating system started by AT&T, GE, MIT, introduced in 1965. After that they developed one more operating system, Unix. Unix stands for Uniplex Information Computing System. Uniplex Information Computing System. It was introduced in 1969. It is implemented by Ken Thompson. So Unix operating system implemented by Ken Thompson. It is introduced in 1969. It is based on Multics operating system. After that there is one more operating system was introduced, Unix. This Unix operating system 100% written in C language. This Unix operating system 100% written in C language. Introduced in 1973. Implemented by Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie is the implementer of C language. Dennis Ritchie is the implementer of C language. Both Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie written this Unix operating system in C language. Okay. Unix is a open source. Open source written in C language. Written in C language by Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie. Dennis Ritchie. So do you know what is open source? Open source means they give complete implementation of this operating system. Means they give source code, and it is open source means they give us complete source code. Complete source code. So based on this Unix operating system, there are some third party vendors implemented Unix operating systems. First one, Solaris. This Solaris is implemented by Sun Microsystems. Sun Microsystems. And there is one more operating system, AIX. It is implemented by IBM. And there is one more operating system, HP UX, implemented by HP. And there are some other operating systems which are implemented based on Unix operating system. And there is one more operating system called Linux operating system. Linux operating system. This Linux operating system also implemented based on this Unix open source code. Okay. This Linux operating system implemented by Linus Torvalds. It is introduced in the year 1991. Okay. Linux operating system is implemented based on Unix operating system. Okay. And it is also a open source. It is also a open source. Linux operating system also a open source. Based on this Linux operating system, around 600 plus operating systems are introduced. 600 plus operating systems are introduced. Okay. These are called Linux distributions. Linux distributions. In this 600 plus operating systems, active operating systems are 300. 300 operating, 300 Linux OSs are active. In that, popular Linux distributions are Red Hat, CentOS, Fedora, Ubuntu, SUSE, and other operating systems. So these are popular Linux operating systems which are implemented based on this Linux open source. Okay. So this Linux operating system implemented based on what? Unix operating system. So Linux is open source, which is implemented by Linus Torvalds. It is introduced in the year of 1991. Unix was introduced in 1969. Okay. Unix is based on what? Unix implemented based on what? Unix. So this Unix is based on what? Multics. Okay. Multics was introduced in 1965. Who is implemented this Multics? AT ante? AT ante? GE and MIT. Unix was introduced by Ken Thompson. It was introduced in the year of 1969. So these Multics, Unix and Unix is open sources. So based on this Unix operating system, multiple operating systems are implemented. In that, Solaris, AX and HPUX are popular. And based on this Unix operating system, Linux operating system was implemented. And this is also a open source operating system. Based on this Linux operating system, 600 plus operating systems were implemented. In that, 300 operating systems are active. In that 300, popular operating systems are Red Hat, CentOS, Fedora, Ubuntu, SUSE and some other operating systems. Okay, let's see Linux operating system structure, architecture. Linux operating system architecture. Linux operating system architecture. Hardware. To communicate with hardware, Linux has kernel. So to communicate with the Linux operating system, to communicate with the hardware, Linux has its own kernel. Not only Linux operating system, every operating system has kernel. So to communicate with kernel, Linux gives us, given us shell. So by using shell, shell is a user interface. So user uses shell. In this, through this shell, user enters commands, Linux commands. These Linux commands are human readable. So hardware cannot understand this human readable instructions. So this cell receives this Linux human readable format commands and converts into kernel understandable format. Kernel receives that human Linux commands and converts that commands hardware understandable format. Here hardware process that commands and gives return results back to kernel, kernel to shell. So this is the Linux operating system architecture. Okay, let's see features of Linux operating system. First feature, it is a open source. So what is open source? So open source means they give us complete source code, and it is free, of cost. It means no license cost. It is completely free. Okay. Second one, it is a multitasking operating system. What is multitasking? At a time, it can process, Multiple tasks. Multiple tasks parallelly. Multiple tasks parallelly. So if you can run any number of tasks parallelly, this operating system can process your tasks parallelly. Okay. And next important feature is, it is a multi-user. Multi-user. What is multi-user operating system? Okay. It at a time, n number of users can log in. N number of users can log in and can use resources. N number of users can log in and n number of can users can use resources. So this is multi operating system. And next very, very important feature of Linux is, it is a portable. Portable. What is portable? So portable means you can install Linux operating system on any hardware. There is no restriction. If you take some of the Unix operating systems like Sun Solaris 100% gives support for Sun hardware. AX operating system gives support for IBM architecture hardware. HP UX support for HP hardware. You can also install Solaris, IBM AX and HP UX and other hardwares, but it cannot give 100% accurate results. Okay, but Linux operating system you can install on any hardware. There is no restriction. Okay, and next very important is, it is reliable. Reliable. Large servers being running successfully without single restart. So large servers running successfully without single restart. Okay, let's discuss Linux file system structure. Root is a parent or main root file system. This is root file system. All other file systems comes under root file system. Okay, in this /boot, this boot directory is very important. All booting files are presented under boot directory. Okay, next /root. Root is a home directory for root user or admin user. In Linux file system, there are two types of users: admin users and non-admin users. By default, when you install any Linux operating system, default admin user is root. For this root user, it will create home directory under this root. And if you create any user, example, if you create user Srinivas, for any non-admin user, it will create home directory under slash home. With username Srinivas. Okay, for any non-admin users, it will create home directory under slash home with username. Okay, if you create any other user, Oracle, it will create one more directory under this slash home with user Oracle. So, for non-admin users, for other users, other than root user, for every user, it will create home directory under slash home with username. Instead of creating in this location, we can also specify other location at the time of user creation. If you're not willing to create a home directory for users with this location, you can specify different location at the time of user creation. If you not specify any location to the user, by default, for every user, home directory created under in this directory. Okay. Next, slash sbin and slash bin. This sbin contain commands for admin. Whatever the commands are presented under sbin directory can be executed uses only admin user. And bin directory contain commands which can be used by admin and other users. So the commands presented under sbin can be used by only admin user, and the commands presented under bin can be used by admin as well as other users. Okay. Next important directory, slash etc. This etc directory contain all configuration files. Example, if you want to find host information, there is a file called slash etc hosts. In this file, you can find configuration of your host information. Okay. So all configuration files are presented under where? Etc directory. And there is one more directory called slash usr. This usr directory contain all installed softwares information. Example, if you install Java, Tomcat, Hadoop, etc. You can find this installed software information from this directory. Okay. Next important directory is slash OPT. OPT stands for optional. OPT stands for optional. In this directory, we install all third party softwares we install in this OPT directory. Okay, next important one directory is slash lib. This lib directory contain all library files, library files for every command presented under sbin and bin. Sbin and bin contain different commands, right? Sbin contain commands for administrator, bin contain commands for admin and non-admin users. So these commands, there is a implementation, right? For every command there is a implementation. We can find that implementation libraries from lib directory. Okay, next there is a important directory slash mnt is a temporary mounting point. So in this directory we mount some temporary drives. Next slash dev. From this directory we can find node files information. What are node files? Example slash SDA. SDA stands for hard disk. Next CD-ROM. CD-ROM stands for CD-ROM, DVD-ROM, DVD-ROM, FD0, floppy disk, etc. So we can found node files information from this directory. Okay, next important directory slash media. This media directory contain defaults removable media information like CD-ROM, DVD-ROM, pen drives, etc. We can find these devices information from media directory. Okay, so there are some other directories are present, but these are main important directories. Okay, so this is Linux file system architecture. Okay, thank you.